Hi, this is the weekly horoscope for Libra for the week of January 28th, 2019. Hello, my Care Bears. And I am still on Cheetah Mobile. And I don't know if you guys saw this, if everybody would stop being on my Instagram, this feature here. And if you see this, this is like people on my Instagram still liking my daily horoscopes. But anyways, they have a new Today's Tarot, and you go to check it out, and you can go ask tarot, and it will, and you can ask it, and it'll ask you like a bunch of questions and stuff, and you can get like a little reading with that, and it'll interpret the cards for you as well. So check that out. If you haven't gotten a Cheetah Mobile daily horoscope app yet, it is free, and unlike other daily horoscope apps, it has a lot more content and a lot more stuff going on, and a bunch of different psychics, and it also has the zodiac, the Chinese zodiac guide for the auspicious, because February 2nd is the Chinese New Year. So check that out as well. Again, it's a free app. You can find the links in the description box below. One is for the Android and the other one is for the iPhone. Also, I have been finding that everybody is starting to come back. So hello, welcome again. If you're trying to look for me, because I know that it's really hard to look for me because I am not a big fish. I'm a little fish in a big giant pond. Make sure to click on the notification bell, and also if you want to know when I am posting my daily transits on my community page, then make sure to subscribe. Okay, show your support to this channel by liking, subscribing, and sharing, and thank you for everyone who has. So this week Mercury is conjunct with Miranda, trining the ascendant in the first and fifth house. The first house is the mask you wear for your friends. The fifth house is karmic love, social media, entertainment, gamers, etc., children. You can be very creative and original in your way of thinking. This is a positive time for those of you in media or social media or anything dealing with electronics or technology. This is a good time for you. You can be more about your social life. Many short trips can happen at this time this week, so you can be very busy with this energy, and you can occasionally discover new and unusual places that you haven't visited it before. Also, this is flashes of insight, but unfortunately, it's like you can hear like these prophetic or these beautiful quotes, and then all of a sudden they're gonna drift away. And that is a sign that spirit is trying to reach out to you and trying to talk to you. Okay, and I love it when that happens. It's just that I don't remember it, and neither will you this week, okay? Friendships will also be very important this week. For others of you, this could be new people coming into your life. This could be a great time for networking and meeting unusual or eccentric people now. You can have unusual experience on Monday. You can do more now to stand out and away from the crowd and be seen more. So this is a great time for job interviews or auditions. You'll be surprised and often delighted by new relationships that are spontaneous and exciting. But, you know, before you jump in and try to say, ooh, that's a permanent thing, you know, wait and see, because Vesta just went into the sign. Not Vesta, who did? Ceres went into the sign of Sagittarius. So now we're all about our damn freedom. So, you know, just be careful with that. You know, date, take it slow, get to know the person to make sure it's a sure thing, okay? And enjoy the moment with this person, okay? I feel that this week, especially Monday, it is not going to be a dull moment. Miranda is trining the sun this week and is conjunct with Mercury as well in the first and fifth house. So this is a great energy also for bloggers, writers, musicians to get your creative juices flowing. You can be following your intuition and starting new projects. You can feel the need to revisit old projects or even people from your past. Unexpected turn of events can happen this week. It may not be by your choice or by your hand at this time. You know, as your situation is changing and you're aligning yourself more with your purpose, sometimes we have to leave behind certain friendships because they are not part of our purpose. They are not part of our journey. It's like that Medea conversation about the tree and how the tree has branches on it, it has roots on it, and the ones with the roots are the ones that are going to stay and never leave. But the branches Sometimes the branches get weak and they break off when there's trouble and stuff, or when, the storm hits, then they break off and they just leave. The leaves represents there's a reason for a season, and this could be one of those things that are happening for you this week. Don't see it as a bad thing. See it as the universe now trying to put you in more alignment with what you want, with your purpose. And sometimes we can't see those things because we are so fixated on the rejection part or the emotional self. So just try to put things in perspective and see it as a good thing, with this energy, okay? Because there is a lot of water going on in the charts this week, so we can be a bit super sensitive at this time. But change is always good, and whoever has to leave your life at this time, let them leave. It's a good thing, okay? Because it's just the universe saying that these people or this situation cannot no longer be on your path at this time because you're growing, you're changing, and you need to go this way, okay? Triton is trining Neptune in the second house of money and possessions with the sixth house of exercise, daily routine, health. You need to delve more into certainty and faith consciousness this week because you can feel things a bit intensely. Okay, it's just the water, and you feel things a bit intensely. So you need to take that intensity that you have, and you need to put it in your power of prayer, in your affirmations. This could be strong emotional bonds that you can be forming with people, or this could be emotional validation or healing energy coming through because you have a deeper understanding about how about certain situations. You may have more of an eye opener for problem solving or just revealing truth and bringing things to light. And you may use this to your advantage, or you may inform others of your findings and if for research or science, or even for therapists. You can also feel things very intensely at this time. So again, this can cause a bit of a depression at this time. So really watch your emotional self and you be proactive and be the deliberate creator that you are, and use this time for the law of attraction, power of prayer, or metaphysics. Pick and choose your thoughts this week. As soon as you start hearing yourself complain, because that is Saturn, the Sun, and Pluto, and Venus now trying to come in the sign of Capricorn and Mercury. So there's a lot of complaining there, and it loves to complain. That's all it does is complain, is bitch and complain about everything. It's beautiful. I love it. I have a lot of planets. I have a stellium in my sign of Capricorn. I am an expert complainer. Give it to me, and I will bitch about it. Okay? And so, that's where all that is coming from. Because as soon as something happens, some little wrench gets thrown in your way, you're like, oh, my life sucks, it's over. That's Capricorn talking to you. So just be aware of the conversation this week, okay? Titan is trining the Sun conjunct with Mercury in the first and fifth house. You can be getting along better with those who are older than you. For some of you, this is finding love with an older person. This can be a fun energy time for you, a great time for those of you in media or social media or the entertainment industry or teachers. Some of you this week can be more about your play, starting new projects, or you can be delving into your hobbies a bit more. This is a positive time for communications, and for those of you in sales, you have to talk to others or to get other people on board with your thoughts and ideas. I mean, you have a way to do it, and people tend to go about and listen to you. This is a good time to analyze any action before you take it in some communication, and this is a time where you're just determined to get what you want, and you will. I feel that you make good points with your words, and people tend to go and follow what you're doing. I don't feel like it's very hard for them to say no at this time. You may not be aware of your power of your words, especially how you can antagonize others, so be careful with that too. So don't go pushing with this energy. You may also be in a situation that demands that you defend your ideas, and if you avoid talking to others and not antagonizing them, and not attacking them personally, you can express yourself with complete confidence. Just choose your battles carefully this week. Mars is quincunx Miranda conjunct with Flores in the second house of money with the seventh house of relationships. You may not be getting along with those who are younger than you, or you could be taking things personally because you expect others to give you respect, or you could be expecting a thank you for all the things that you have done, and you're not getting it, okay? So at this time, again, pick and choose your battles with people, okay? Because they may not be noticing it. They could be more in their moment and in their feelings at this time. They can be taking credit for your stuff, you know? So it's a bunch of situations that can happen at this time. So be careful with this. I feel like this is very antagonistic energy at this time. So I would just leave sleeping dogs lie and see what transpires. Because sometimes it's just, you know, it's a conversation, you know, even though you're in the moment, you feel like saying something, but it's always a conversation that you can come back to later on, okay? Or you could privately have a conversation with that person and see what was mulling in their head, or let them know how you feel in a week from now or something, or when you get them in a quiet space, you know. The first card I come up with is the Two of Swords. I feel like this is reevaluating relationships at this time and questioning people's loyalty with this energy. Ooh, somebody has a question. The Page of Coins. Let me see. Okay. The Page of Cups. I feel like for some of you, this is dealing with an on-again, off-again relationship. For others of you, because it was in reverse, this is not dealing with an on-again, off-again relationship, but this could be somebody coming back from your past. This could be child or somebody thinking about you at this time and wanting to reconnect with you. It doesn't mean that they will, because everybody has free will, but know that you're being thought of or you can hear about them this week. The Four of Coins, I feel for some of you, this could be worries at this time. So this could be over children with this energy, and you could be worried about your children, or this could be money worries coming up at this time. You could feel the pressures of work with this energy here. But you know, watch your emotional self, because it is up and down. And then one more card, the Six of Cups. So the answer, whatever question you were looking for this week, is yes. I feel like you can be sentimental about the past at this time, and you can be rehashing the past in your mind. And that's because there's a lot of water in the charts right now with the North Node. And of course, Chiron is leaving next month to go into the sign of Aries. So we need to be careful at this time not to confuse whatever it is that's bubbling up, making us mad, sad, angry, happy. Not to confuse that with our reality, because then we hold on to things, you know? So we need to let those things go that Chiron is bringing up and saying, okay, we need to like process this. Okay, we need to get this psychic junk out, because that's all it's doing, is removing psychic junk and subconscious junk that our brain does not need anymore, okay? The Five of Coins, have faith that things will work itself out this week. The Hierophant card, I feel like for some reason, even though you need to be more in gratitude at this time, for some of you, you're going to be having a bit of a pity party going on. So watch your emotional self. That could be that North Node in Cancer talking to you at this time, because Cancers love to throw themselves pity parties. Dude, I love my Cancers, but you know. The Nine of Swords, I feel, definitely get the hell out of your damn head this week. It is not the place to be. You're too much in your feelings. The Knight of Swords, I feel like this could be a busy week and you can feel overwhelmed. So you may have to take breaks or do something nice for yourself in the middle of the week. The Six of Wands, I feel like this is optimistic energy. So this energy to me looks like it's going to be a roller coaster ride of energies. I feel like also you could be doing something with the family and trying to bring family members back together again, or trying to reconnect people with each other at this time as well. The Emperor card, I feel for some of you that you may leave certain situations in the name of integrity at this time. I feel that other people in your life, especially the men in your life, can be a bit stubborn in their way of thinking. So you can be playing a waiting game with them at this time and not saying anything or making any decisions as a way to manipulate the situation. The Six of Coins, I do see that for some of you, this is pray, this is whatever church you've been giving tithings to or donating to, pray that this church or spiritual institution will have your prayers answer for you with this energy. And normally when this comes up with the Six of Coins and the Hierophant card, normally prayers will get answered at this time, all right? The Ten of Coins, there's an emphasis on money coming up. There's money worries happening, and then there's money coming in. So this could be good news with a loan during this time period as well. And the Seven of Swords, I feel like for some of you, this is going to be a time where you kind of need to be careful what you say around certain people, because they could be looking to get you in trouble this week, or they can be gossiping behind your back with this energy. I love you, my Care Bears. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and share. Kisses. Mwah.